can't get out of this stuff. Y'all don't want to talk to the preacher? Yeah, everybody got something at stake here. It takes a negotiation to get out of it. And so Abram had a negotiation. Abram had a negotiation with Lot. This Abram negotiation with Lot. Y'all got more time? Y'all got a little more time? But this Abram negotiation with Lot right here. Abram go to Lot, and he said, look here, man, this ain't working for both of us. I should have left you back there in Ur, or the Chaldeans, but I took you, and God told me not to bring you. And now, all Hades is breaking loose. All
right.
We don't work good together. And you're going to be all right, but you can't be with me. See, the problem with us is we think if God don't bless people through us, that God won't bless us. But God don't need you to bless people. God bless people you don't even like. God say, let them go. And if you let them go, I'll take care of them. But I can't take care of them because you won't take your hands off of them. Get away from them and trust them to me, and I'll fight them. That's why I told you to raise your children in the way they should go. Let them go. I got them. What is Abram's negotiation? This brings Abram's negotiation right here. He said, now, I never should have brought you. It was a mistake. It wasn't going to work. God told me to stop, but it wasn't going to work. Everybody knows God told them that once they get out of it. Don't you know that? They do. God told them that word. That's why people come to me, they say, what should I do? What's going on? I say, you know. Yeah, you know what's happening. You know what's happening. No, I don't. If I knew, I wouldn't be in here with you. Okay, but you know. And then when they come back 6 months later, they say, Pastor, I knew all the time, always. Because they know. So if you say that, just tell the truth. I knew I wasn't supposed to bring you. And God said, now look up. He didn't tell him to move and look up. He didn't tell him to move and look up. He didn't tell him to go over there and look up. He didn't tell him, are you close to it? But look up. When you get there, I'll stare you. He said, right where you're standing, right here, look up. In other words, he says, Abram, you were not able to know where you were because you were so connected to where you've been. You already in a blessed place. But you can't see your blessings because you're too connected to your past. You're too connected to the curses that you've been through to understand that you're blessed right now. Somebody would understand that their husband was a better husband if they got over what their daddy did.
Yeah.
Somebody would understand that wife is a better wife if they got over what their mama did. Yeah. In other words, he said, you're too connected to that you don't even know what you got right now. Yeah. He didn't say, take a step. He said, now, look up. From right here, because it's not the geography, it's not the geographic place that keeps you from being blessed where you are. It may not even be the wrong job. It's how much of the old job you got in. That's why I'm not telling you it's your marriage, because it might not be your marriage, it might be your last marriage. All right. Ooh, you all talk to me. Yeah. Oh, y'all playing me now? You're going to slow down, man. I said, no, for that. All right, I'll take your cue. I'll take your little cue. Look up from where you are. Tell your neighbor, look up, baby. Tell your neighbor, look up. Look up, you know. If you look up right now, you'll see some stuff that you never seen before. Look up. Don't move. Look up. Change your disposition and look up. Change your mindset. Get back to yesterday's party, said, look up. And he said, and when you look up, you will fall down in the stars. And every star that you see up there is a representative of a person that I'm going to bring out of your family. for you.